Hello, this is your daily dose of news from On Manorama. I'm your host Swati Ajit and these are the major news stories of Sunday, July 21st, 2024. The 14-year-old boy who contracted the Nipah virus infection breathed his last while undergoing treatment at Kozhikode Government Medical College Hospital on Sunday. The child from Malappuram was on ventilator support. Bangladesh's top court on Sunday reduced a controversial quota system for government job applicants, making a partial victory for student protesters after days of nationwide unrest and deadly clashes with police. 12 rescue personnel from India on Sunday joined the Nepali security forces in their search for several missing passengers on two buses that were washed away by a landslide into a swollen river in Nepal last week. The US criticized the breadth of the International Court of Justice's opinion that Israel's occupation of Palestinian territories is illegal, with Washington saying it would complicate efforts to resolve the conflict. The Supreme Court is scheduled here on Monday a batch of petitions related to the controversy-ridden medical entrance exam, NEET UG 2024, which was held on May 5th. Let us get into the details. The 14-year-old boy who contracted the Nipah virus infection breathed his last while undergoing treatment at Kozhikode Government Medical College Hospital on Sunday. The child from Malappuram was on ventilator support. Health Minister Veena George told the media that the child suffered a massive cardiac arrest around 10:50 a.m. on Sunday. The death was confirmed around 11:20 a.m. The boy's condition deteriorated before the monoclonal antibody procedure from Australia could be administered. Meanwhile, four people listed in the high-risk category of the boy's contact list are undergoing treatment at the Manjeri Medical College Hospital. Among them, one person is admitted to the ICU. Bangladesh's top court on Sunday scaled back a controversial quota system for government job applicants. This decision marks a partial victory for student protesters. The ruling follows days of nationwide unrest and deadly clashes between police and demonstrators. The violence has resulted in scores of fatalities. Students frustrated by shortages of good jobs have been demanding an end to a quota that reserved 30% of government jobs for relatives of veterans who fought in Bangladesh's War of Independence in 1971. The government previously halted it in 2018 following a mass student protests, but in June, Bangladesh's High Court reinstated the quotas and set off a new round of protests. 12 rescue personnel from India on Sunday joined the Nepali security forces in their search for several missing passengers on two buses that were washed away by a landslide into a swollen river in Nepal last week. The Indian rescue team from the National Disaster Response Force reached Bagmati province's Chitwan on Saturday at the request of Nepal. Several Indian nationals were in one of the buses. The bodies of three of them have been recovered so far. Nepal sought assistance from India to carry out a search operation for the buses that swept into the Trishuli River after a landslide hit the region on July 12th. The US criticized the breadth of the top UN court's opinion that Israel's occupation of Palestinian territories is illegal, with Washington saying it would complicate efforts to resolve the conflict. The International Court of Justice, or the World Court, said on Friday that Israel's occupation of Palestinian territories and settlements was illegal and should be ended as soon as possible, delivering its strongest findings to date on the Israeli-Palestinian conflict. The State Department said the ICJ opinion that Israel must withdraw as soon as possible from the Palestinian territories was inconsistent with the established framework for resolving the conflict. The Supreme Court is scheduled here on Monday a batch of petitions related to the controversy-ridden medical entrance exam, NEET UG 2024, which was held on May 5th. The National Testing Agency had on Saturday released city and centre-wise results of the medical entrance exam, which is riddled with accusations of paper leak and inordinate inflation of marks. According to the course list of July 22nd, uploaded on the Apex Court's website, a bench comprising Chief Justice D.Y. Chandrachud and Justices J.B. Pardiwala and Manoj Mishra would hear more than 40 pleas. These include pleas filed by the NTA, seeking the transfer of cases pending against it in various high courts on the NEET UG row to the Supreme Court. The aim is to avoid the multiplicity of litigations. That brings us to the end of this episode. Thanks for listening to Daily News Dose, hosted by me, Swati Ajit, and produced by Vishnu Murlitharan with technical support from Idea Brew Studios. Follow www.onmoon.com for detailed updates on the latest news and be sure to come back tomorrow.